followers who've also kind of probably been victims of the hate machine.
Yeah, yeah, hopefully.
So adamant about not hating Muslims because the hatred of Muslims allowed us to beg for our own enslavement. It's like, well, we need the Patriot Act or else we can't find the bad terrorists. You think Muslims just hate Ariana Grande and the Boston Marathon? They used the media to drum up this hatred of Muslims so that we would beg for our own enslavement, you know?
What do you think of the first thing? He said some points about our enslavement, you know, of making an enemy.
Right.
And then we end up enslaving ourselves because of this fake enemy.
Right. I think that's a good analysis. You create a boogeyman to drum up fear, and then people are more willing to accept your program, right? So he mentions the Patriot Act. He mentions, there are so many things that you can just look at with that alone. But, I mean, we've lived through 9/11. I was, you know, in high school when that happened. And that was something that completely changed the course of American history in terms of domestic policy, because you had all of these new laws, surveillance. Okay, the idea that every single phone call that you make, every single text message, email, every communication is now being monitored, that has a really stifling effect. So why would the public agree to that violation of privacy? The only way that they accept it is because, oh, well, there's a bigger threat. If you don't accept this, there's going to be another 9/11. There's going to be all kinds of chaos. So you have to accept all our restrictions, all of this grabbing of power by the president, George Bush, later Barack Obama, and you accept it because you're afraid for your life. So you're blackmailing people. You're holding the public hostage. It's a great point.
Great point. Yeah. So when someone is open-minded enough and they look at the facts on the ground, the reality, it reminds me of Professor Robert Pape from the University of Chicago and other academics like him, terrorist experts, and they just blow this myth out of the sky, you know, that Islam is some kind of threat and people are based off Islam, they're doing these terrorist acts. He mentions that Islam had nothing to do with it. This is geopolitical. This is nothing to do with the religion of Islam. When you have, these are non-Muslims saying that.
Yeah, so Muslims have been in the modern world. We've had all of these Muslim countries. What, did suddenly a switch go off in 2001 that now they want to, you know, destroy America and destroy the West just because of hatred, you know, hating their freedoms? Makes no sense. Like, what about all of these generations, decades of modernity, right? The modern world where you have these nation states, these Muslim countries have been broken up, basically dividing and conquering the Ummah. And so only now, suddenly there's this existential threat because of terrorism from people hiding in caves. It doesn't make sense. And I think as time goes on, more and more people are going to see how ridiculous it sounds. And hopefully, you know, in history books will show that the public was manipulated and people were driven to make completely irrational decisions for themselves and for others in their treatment of Muslims and their consideration of Islam because of these stories, mm-hmm. right? In Arabic, qisas, right? These are just stories. So it's unfortunate, but alhamdulillah, I'm glad that people like this, Owen Benjamin, is speaking openly about it.
Yeah. So a few of the elite can go ahead and profit off of these wars, make money and feed the war machine, and then divide the people like what's been happening. It seems like he's woken up to this.
Right.
Yeah.